the cushion. So make sure you can feel the sit bones and move that fleshy part of the butt so that you have nice firm placement. And just start some little circles to make sure everything is in place. So our second part of connection to the root energy. And then imagine the bottom of the tailbone, the base of the tailbone. So this is actually the root chakra. And then each vertebrae of the spine lining up in the lovely discs between each vertebrae filled with fluid, providing some cushioning between those vertebrae. And they're lined up nice and tall like a ladder. Up the back, the neck, connecting to the brain stem, skull, and the top of the skull, the top of the head, the crown chakra, reaching up towards the ceiling, the heavens, connecting us to the universe. Just taking a moment to establish the rootedness at our feet and the bottom of our pelvis. And the universal energy running to the top of our head. And just for a few moments, make some Jerry Lewis, Jim Carrey faces. You can't open your eyes for this, really. Shift around the focus of the eyes, make circles, bring them into the center so you go double vision. And I know it's kind of weird for us, but look side to side, all around. Open the mouth wide. And then once you feel like you've stretched those eye muscles and every facial muscle, bring it to stillness and ease. The upper and lower jaw, there's a space between them, and the tongue is just behind the two front teeth in fire point. And the hands are just gently on our laps. And then we begin to concentrate on the breath. But first, just monitor the breath and what's going on with your breath today. Are you able to breathe through your nose? Is your breath slow and even, or is it pitchy? Is it more up in the top of the chest, or are you able to come down into the belly? We're not changing anything at the moment. We're just observing. Observation of the breath will also enable you to really become connected to what else is going on within you today. So if your mind is scattered, if your emotions are all over the place or in a bad spot, maybe physical pain or tension, those will all come back and affect the breath. And just like we can affect the breath, and change our breath, and that can bring some change to our physical, mental, emotional being as well. So just observing first. And then we're going to begin to actually try to alter our breath, and we're going to concentrate on inhaling in and out through the nose. And on the breath in, we want to focus on the breath coming in and moving down so that our lungs expand as the lung diaphragm moves down and right into the pelvic floor diaphragm. So you want to feel a little bit of a downwards pressure on that pelvic floor into our cushions on an inhale. And then when you exhale, you want that exhale to actually begin again at the pelvic floor as it lifts up, and then the lung diaphragm lifts up, and we slowly, gently expel the breath. We want the inhale and the exhale to be slow. We want them to be smooth, and we want them to be deep. And we want to minimize forcefulness, it's easiness we're trying to bring in. And as we participate in a slow, smooth, deep, sends messages from our organs, our heart, and our stomach, up to the brain, letting the brain know, should we be freaking out and going into fight or flight response? Or is everything okay and we can relax and restore? So that smooth, even, deep abdominal breath brings us to a state of peace and tranquility. Moments just coming into contact, developing that deep lateral diaphragmatic breath in, slow, smooth, easy breath out. And the reason we also want a slow, smooth, easy breath out is we want to keep some of that CO2 within our bodies. Our bodies use the CO2, it affects the alkalinity of our blood. It helps the efficiency of our digestive system. And the carbon dioxide actually helps the oxygen get to the different cells of the body. So we want to keep that CO2 in. And it's not CO2 that we take in from the external environment. It's CO2 we create within our own bodies that's utilized. So we don't want to just let that go. A few more slow, even breaths. Everybody bring their hands together at the center of their chest in namaste and press the thumbs to the sternum. Just feeling the heart beating beneath our thumbs. Coming into contact with our soul, our spirit, our heart beating, our life force. And we'll start with a little prayer. So today, as we go about our yoga practice, may we remember we are not our physical bodies, we are not our thoughts or our feelings, we are not what we see, hear, smell, taste, nor touch, for the true self is beyond the mere senses. Our bodies are a beautiful cathedral that hold our souls, which are boundless, limitless, ever free. For our spirit, yesterday is no more. Tomorrow is unknown. All we have is this moment now, God's gift of the present. And just bow your head down to the hands. Keep pressing the palms into one another. Have the forearms parallel to the floor. Just bring that chin right down towards the center of your chest and feel the lovely stretch up the back body. And just begin to create little smiley faces, moving the chin towards one armpit and the other. So we're creating a little smile with our chins. Slow stretch, slow breath. If on the journey of the chin there's a special spot of sweetness that says, ah, that feels really good there, then just stop and breathe in that spot. And then once it feels like it's loosened, continue the journey of the smile. A couple more, just watch that the breath is still even, still coming down to the pelvic floor. And gently raising up. We don't want to feel any kind of wind on the top lip as we exhale. There's barely a breeze. Then the next time you come to the sternum, raise up to neutral. So your chin is parallel to the floor. We're still pressing those hands and it's working the arms. And I'm sure you're just starting to get tired. And then we're just going to bring the head from side to side. So looking over towards one side and the other, and it's just the head moving right now. And same, if there's a spot that feels like, oh, I really want to hang out, it's a lovely stretch, hang out and breathe to the stretch. Imagine gold healing light gently warming, massaging, loosening the muscle tension. creating now a rainbow effect with that chin. Still concentrating on slow, smooth breaths, the sensations. And is there any time you want to just stop, settle in the stretch? Just a few more. I know our arms are getting tired here. And then next time, right center, just bring it back down. Let the arms come down alongside. Laser beam the fingers, so spread the fingers. And then let's make choo-choo arms. So it's like we're the old-fashioned locomotion on the wheels. So shoulders up and back and forward. Keep those hands nice and open and splayed. So right now we're working a little bit more with a masculine energy. It's more precise, a little bit, I'm gonna say, stiffer. And change direction. So now it's like we're bringing that choo-choo backwards in reverse. And then just bring the hands on top of the lat, nice and tall. And just observe for a moment the sensations running from on the top of the body. And we're going to bring our center again. And today we're going to add a little bit of a prayer to our normal heart opening pose. So just take a moment, feel that spirit beating beneath your thumbs. And today we're going to still do the same basic motions, but we're going to add a little bit of our metta. So bring your soul into it, and then we're going to open up. May I be filled with love and kindness. May I be well. And bring it down to your heart, at the heart center. May I be peaceful and at ease. And then lift up. May I be happy. And come back down. May I be filled with love and kindness. May I be well. May I be peaceful and at ease. May I be happy. Back to heart. And one more time. May I be filled with love and kindness. May I be well. May I be peaceful and at ease. May I be happy. And bring your hands down. Bring them onto your lap. And just bring them close to your knees and kind of give a little bit of a squeeze. So we're activating. We want to make sure our chests are open, our shoulders are back and down. And remember that we want to make sure our lung diaphragm and our pelvic floor diaphragms are what's parallel. So we can have a nice deep full breath. And then we're going to come into our shell butterfly. So just take a breath in and exhale here. And next time we take a breath in, we just want to bring our chest forward. We're creating that round, rounding the back. And then exhale, rounding the back the other way. Go into your shell like you're a snail. Inhale in, you become a butterfly. And exhale, go into your shell. Just take this at your own pace. Try to take the whole full inhale to really round the front body. We're stretching from our pelvic floor up to the crown of our head, and the back is contracting. And then on an exhalation, we're stretching out the back muscles and contracting the whole front body. Nice movement for our spine, for our ligaments and our muscles, or our core muscles. And our core is made up of our abdominal muscles and our back muscles. And again, you can always just bring that physical aspect in. You can bring the spiritual aspect in if you think about the heart non-harm. So we want to be loving and kind, but also we want to protect ourselves. A couple more. And then bring yourselves just to center. So we can bring your arms down, or if you're feeling strong and you want to work your arms a little bit more, we can bring them into that Y. You're going to take a breath in here. And exhale, come over to the side. So work where you can today, so the arms aren't necessarily important. You can keep the arms down. If you have the arms up, try to keep them in those laser beams so we're really working the arms and shoulders. So moving the spine in a lateral direction, nice stretch along one side, all the way from this foot up to the middle fingers. Make sure you're grounding the feet and the sit bones. It's great for the digestive system. As we move here, we're getting those organs squeezing, so it's all good. And then make sure we even up. So the next asana we're going to do is a little bit actually of a qigong move, and we're going to be twisting, but it's also a qigong move. So we're going to grab that energy at our pelvic area and just take a few moments to really feel the energy circulating here. And in qigong, the energy center is here, and also in yoga, it's believed that the prana is actually activated in our lower belly. So we're just going to take a moment to come to stillness. And then what we're going to do is we're going to inhale and exhale here. So everybody exhale. We're going to keep no breath. And we're going to turn from with our belly button over towards your left. Once we're here, we're going to inhale, we're going to bring that energy in, lifting our arms up, inhaling, bring our hands to the top of our head, hold the breath in, come back to center, exhale, let it go, hold here, we've got no breath, come over to the other side, inhale, bring the energy in, hold, come back to center, exhale. Hold with no breath. Twist. Inhale in. Hold. Center. Exhale out. Hold the energy. No breath. Twist. Inhale in. Come to center. Exhale. So you can continue at your own pace. More to each side. One more to each side. We really want that digestive system and all our energy to work. We're going to just start tapping right at the hips. Just both hands to start on both sides. And then we're going to come to the right side. So everybody's going to their right side and then come up and over to down to the left. And we're just going to make these little circles. So if you had a big breakfast before you came, don't act so hard. Otherwise, just keep patting. Couple more rounds around the belly area. And end on the right side. And then we're going to come to our back. So coming up and down our back.
What's that?
I feel really not very high.
Well, one hand is probably moving a different beat than the other. It's okay.
Just hold. I feel I'm hopeless.
Just do the best you can. It's I think it's right or wrong.
Doing skating with the girls, we put a Christmas concert on, and a bunch of the mothers decided we're going to do a number on this thing, and we're making our costumes and everything, and having practices, and we're all showing off what we can do. I tried to spin right down, broke my arm 5 months before I got to fix my arm. So much for skating, I didn't try that again.
So they come back down to the bottom, and then we're going to come down and go. And come down, and then up the inside of the leg. Right, and you always see those people doing qigong or tai chi, and you think, oh, they're not really working anything.
Oh.
Yes,
I don't believe you are.
Couple more. Respond. I wanted to do a Tarzan yell here, but you want to keep that energy in. And then we're going to top through the top of our right shoulder, and then we're going to go down the inside of the arm and up the outside. And this stimulates the brain and as well as our immune system. And I know we have an autoimmune disease, but we are stimulating it in a good way. One more to that side, and then start tapping at the top. So this is what activates to the brain. And then down the inside of the arm. And to the outside. And let's do one more. And just for a second at the top of the shoulder, a couple more of the chest. And then just hold and breathe. And take a moment to really just enjoy that whole energy flowing and a little zinging throughout your body. As long as there's no pain, burning, pins and needle sensations. And then bring your hands down. So we're going to grab our block and bring it between our knees. So we've worked the top of the body. Now we're going to begin to work the bottom. So we're just going to squeeze the block and just let it go. Squeeze, activate those inner thigh muscles. Now when we're squeezing the block, just watch that you're not squeezing your bum. That's kind of hard to do. So we're just trying to isolate the leg muscles.
That's
you want to keep, yeah, I know. So there is obviously a tiny bit, but you want to, you're not trying to work the sphincter. We're not grasping our glute muscles. It's about these inner thigh muscles. So you can keep there with the smallest setting, or you can work it a little harder, put it to the next setting. Just watch, because sometimes as we expand, we can start getting little cramps in our legs. Just keep squeezing, sitting upright. And because we're on this balance cushion, we're working our core muscles. lecture, let's make sure that each toe is taking part in the journey. And then watch on this journey. If suddenly your fingers start going and your face starts going, right? Because
all this, I hate my feet. That's how it all cracks.
Yep.
It's like, no.
I had it on my video a few weeks ago that I think, other than fatigue, the one thing that everybody with MS to me seems to have is issues with their feet. Either have numbness or crazy sensation, and sometimes at the same time. So, a couple more. And then we're going to grab our belts. I'm just going to grab the belt. And you want to make it a fairly decent size circle, not too wide. We're going to bring that on around our thighs. So you don't want to make it too big, because then you're going to cause yourself pain by trying to spread your legs too wide apart. And you also, but then you want to work it, so you don't want it too close together. So you want the feet to kind of be just outside of the chair seat.
Yeah.
And bring that buckle into the center so that you're not hurting yourself. Sit nice and upright. And the toes slightly out. Because if we go in, then we're going to cause knee pain and spasms. So just slightly up, sit nice and tall, and then try to break the belt with your outer thigh. Now, while we're doing this, to bring relaxation, close your eyes and concentrate on that diaphragmatic breath. So the legs are spreading, they're trying to break the belt, but the inner mind, the inner heart, the inner breath is just working on settling and being relaxed. So deep inhales down to the bottom of the pelvic floor, and on an exhale you can feel that pelvic floor lift, belly button towards the stomach. And even though it looks like we're not working, I can say that I can really feel it. In your thighs, right into your hips. So watch, if you start feeling like you're cramping, take a break and make that spread between the legs a little less. You don't want to go into cramps here, these spasms. Watch the whole foot is placed down. Watch that you're not clenching your toes, clenching your face. So we're going to start with pressing. We're going to work one side at a time. We're really going to tire it up today versus going back and forth. If you find yourself getting tired, then go back and forth. Otherwise, we're going to really work one leg at a time. So we'll all start by pressing in our right foot. So the right foot is totally activated, and the right sit bone is activated. Sit nice and tall. Inhale in, exhale. And then inhale, you're just going to lighten your left foot, or you're going to raise it up an inch and then bring it down. And then keep going every breath. The smaller you make the move, the more you're actually using your core muscles, your core stabilizers. So if you go up high, what ends up happening is this is just momentum. And it's really easy, but then if you also notice you're shifting. So the slower you go, the more intensity, the more strength we're using. Take a break if you need to. Don't lift it up as high. Keep it, just lighten it. Okay, so it's important that we keep this erectness of the spine, our cores are engaged. And bring it down and just rotate on your cushion. Make sure you go both directions. You can sit nice and tall, and we're going to press down with that left foot, and then right foot is just lifting. So again, be mindful that don't even lift. So you going back and forth, or are you doing one leg at a time? Okay, so press this one in, and then you're just going to barely lift this one up. There we go. Okay, see how that now you're working?
Yeah, I can feel it much better.
Okay, so
yep.
Just,
thank you.
It's not important how high, right? We want to go high because that's, it's like we always want to aim higher.
Yeah.
But that's not what this is about. It's about keeping that core still. So
it's amazing.
Right, just little moves. Sometimes I think the smaller the move, the more difficult it is because it takes, it's like walking.
I'm contributing on that.
Yeah. I said to my neurologist, I said, I walk really fast and then I don't look so off balance as when I try to walk slow. I'm like a drunk.
Yeah.
He says that's exactly what happens, right? As you motor along, you're really using momentum versus strength.
Oh, of course.
So keep it small and use strength. More, and then bring the knees together. Oh. And take a few breaths and relax. And then we're going to come off our cushions. So you have the chair in front of you, and actually bring the chair around so that the seat is facing the middle. Bring your feet up, just keep your belt close by. So sit nice and upright. Try not to lean right back into the chair. I'll watch you for a second. Just lean back. Spread the legs. We'll pretend we're in Shavasana. So just close your eyes. Spread the legs so the feet come outwards. Modified Shavasana. So take a few breaths. Let's go to our nice, deep, smooth inhalation. And then we're going to open the eyes. You try not to sit up against the chair seat, if you can. And then let's bring our toes towards our nose and our heels away. And sit nice and tall in our modified staff pose. So engaging the belly, shoulders relaxed. So remember the two diaphragms are parallel to one another. Really press the toes towards the nose and the heels up. And then just one foot at a time if we were pedaling. Pressing the brake in the gas. I guess you wouldn't really use 2 feet, but I guess one could be the clutch. And then spread them in, toes in, toes out, windshield wiper. Let that whole leg come in and out. Bring the chair a little closer to you. So one, we're going to leave our right foot out. And you're going to bring the left foot on, the knee bent, and sit nice and upright. You know, we're gonna have fun with a nice little twist. So just like we normally twist, you're gonna think was sitting nice and upright, take a breath in. And on an exhale, we're going to move that belly button towards the outer thigh on the bent knee. So Betty the other way. And then just breathe. Slowly in breaths. Come back to center on an inhale. And then if you can, turn so that your sole of your foot is just against the calf and sit nice and upright here. And then take an inhale in, and if it feels okay, you're just going to come from the pelvic bones, from the hip bones, you're just going to come slightly into a forward bend. Not far. Make sure your spine's staying erect. Keep the shoulders, watch your shoulders, so bring those shoulders back. Inhale, bring that left foot down, and you're going to take your belt and bring it around your right fleshy part of your foot, so make sure it's on the fleshy part, not in the instep, because there's no meat there to protect it, and you're just going to grasp that loop, sit nice and tall, and then see if you can just slightly raise it off. The heel is coming forward, the toes towards the nose, in this modified Supta Pedagusta Asana. So stretching up the whole back of the leg. Make sure we haven't pressed the knee right down, there should be a slight bend. Exhale, the belly button is coming towards that other knee bent. So twists are great for detoxification, especially on a Monday morning after St. Patty's Day. Let's clear those digestive systems. Nice and tall. And then sit. sit around the mount of the left foot. Watch that you're not grasping at the buckle. Sit nice and tall. And extend heel towards the front, toes to the nose. Nice little hamstring stretch. Right in the hip.
I just went a little too far.
Keep a little bit of bend in the knee, that helps. No? Cramping?
Yeah.
So let go, bend, and just loosen. And then once you feel like it might have gone away, then you can try again for a minute. So belt come off, and then let both feet come down, and just shake it out, and stand up. Oh, actually, no, we're not standing up yet. Forgot about
our marbles.
Our marbles. Lots of marbles.
Yeah,
we're playing games today.
So we're going to start with the your off piece. So you can move. We're going to start with the ball.
So we don't need the chair, right?
No, the chair can be this side. So just grab the ball and you're going to start just with a little bit of a massage. And just rotate around, trying to get all the parts of the foot. And you can be as gentle or as much pressure as you want. So depending how your feet are feeling today, how you're feeling. Getting some stimulation to the bottom of our foot.
So the rubber ball would be better than the tennis ball? Because I use a tennis ball for everything. Does it really?
The rubber ball is just a little bit firmer. The tennis ball is okay too. You don't want one of those squishy balls though.
I always have a tennis ball.
Yeah, a tennis ball is fine. It's just this is a little, it is a little stiffer.
Okay.
But it's fine. Tennis balls can be stiff. They're stiff enough. She lost her ball.
Oh,
there you go. Well, how did it wind up that way?
And then you're going to put it in the arch, and you're going to push down the heel, and then move to the toe. So heel, toe, and it's not pleasant. I don't find it pleasant, but we want to have that ability for the foot to move.
Okay.
Right. So what happens is our feet flatten, and that's when we get bunions. And just, you know, if you walk like this, or do you want to be able to walk like this? Right. So this will help the what do we call it? The articulation in the foot.
Ooh, the articulation.
Whoa, articulation. Word of the day.
Yeah. Articulation when you're speaking.
Isn't it articulation?
Articulation is your
Isn't it when we articulate articulation?
Maybe I'm using the wrong word.
No, articulation is how you speak.
Yeah.
But I think you're we'll have to look it up.
Yeah. I've never heard that, so
it would be a synonym. Is there a synonym?
It could be, two words have two different meanings. And we all have speech problems. But it's okay. The only way we can help our speech problems is by laughing. And watch that our fingers aren't articulating. We have to Google it.
Yes.
Before the end of class. Oh, we were supposed to, we were supposed to rub first. We were so intent on our...
Oh, have we changed feet?
No. Yes. Oh. I think he did, didn't
you? No.
No, I don't know. I've been working that right.
Usually if it's the foot that is not... lovely, then that's the one you'll be like, ah, I want to get rid of it. You don't want to do it on this side anymore. So. It's a nice massage first. A couple more of those toes and heels. And then we're going to have lots of fun with the marble. Now you might need to take, I know you have the toe socks, but you might need to take the socks off. I'm not sure how that's going to work with the marble. It's hard enough with no socks.
That should be fun.
And then put the ball away. Just watch that you kind of out of your way so you don't trip. So we've all got some marbles. You're going to put them in the center. So the second part of the challenge would be using the cup, but we will start without the cup. So what you're going to do is you're going to grab a marble with, first of all, the big toe and the next big toe, right? And you're going to grab it, and you want to pick it up, and if you can, grab it and put it in the cup.
Oh, in the cup.
And if not, if it's getting it right into the cup is hard, then just move it over to the side. So it doesn't matter. The cup just makes it a little bit more difficult.
One foot at a time, right?
Oh, sorry, one toe. So I just did the same toe. So make sure you're going to the next toe.
Yeah. That's not so easy.
No. And then bring it over.
I haven't got one up yet.
And the next toe. So we keep going until, and it's the dropping of them is not the easiest thing either. You really think it would be. that toe always seems to stick. I can't get rid of it. So
between the toes?
Yep, so between the toes. Or like underneath. So it's like,
yeah.
So right now I'm trying to pick it up with the two smaller ones and then bring it over.
Okay.
See if you can drop it. So for some reason I can't drop these things for the life of me.
I can't even get it
picking it up. Is, yeah.
And then the next part is then taking them back from the outside, grasping them.
I have really stupid toes.
No, we all have stupid. Watch, and we're all having the same issue. But what
this
we want to do is
concentration.
Concentration and.
Where is it? Is it in my phone?
Yeah, it is. I know. I can't get it out.
Okay.
I've picked it up, but I can't. Oh, there
we go. There we go. That wiggled it. Okay.
And then try not to use your fingers.
So now the next four go the opposite way?
Yeah, so once you got to one side, you gotta bring them back.
Oh.
Yeah, I know. Fun with Dick and Jane.
Come on. Oh, this is laughing yoga today.
Yeah, it's laughing therapy.
Oh, I obviously have no muscles in my toes at all.
This is not an easy
game. No, it is
not an easy game. Do the best you can.
And then once you're done that side, then you go to the other side. And probably all of us started with our easier foot at that, so this one. So it's from the center to the side, and then.
Oh, I can't pick up one.
Okay, foot number one.
My fingers are getting involved. Oh, well.
Okay.
Sticky soles.
Just for that.
And then once you've done both feet and all the toes, then pick up the marbles and put them back in the cup because otherwise they'll be falling all over the place later.
Hold on, I don't get this.
That's fine. Just take your time.
Oh, it's in there, I think. That's a weird feeling.
Yeah, you can't get it out.
It's a really weird feeling. I'll just use the cup to help
you. You gotta do what you gotta do.
That's gonna be separate. Yeah, these ones are easier. That's weird.
Okay.
I say that. These long toes, they should be a grip.
You're going quick on that.
Oh.
Yay!
Oh.
So maybe just take a second, put the feet, close the eyes, and just feel the sensations in your feet.
Mm-hmm.
Like, have they not, like, suddenly they're
alive.
Oh. No. So, again, it doesn't cost a lot. It's something you can, but it's important because we need to be able to move all the joints in the foot. Right?
Yeah.
Think about if you ever saw somebody who doesn't have the mobility and how much more difficult it is to walk. Because when we walk, we really want to be able to move through all positions of the foot, right? And if all you can do is move like this,
mm-hmm.
what's your gait going to be like?
Right.
So, why the clothespins? Aha!
Mm-hmm.
Well, just like in our, I've been noticing I've been having some issues with my hands and the dexterity in my hands. So, these are for the dexterity in it. So, you start with, just go,
your
normal one,
right?
This one's
right?
easy. Right? Just open, close. Yeah. You can go to the next, so the middle finger, and open, close.
Yeah, this hand's easy.
Then go to the next, so go to your ring finger. And then pinky finger.
Oh.
Not. Then go back again. So and try to not have try to use only one hand, right?
Mm-hmm.
So try to make it a fluid motion. This is my dad. This is the hand I've been experiencing some issues with. So,
and then
okay.
Switch.
And then switch.
Hello.
Just a few times. And obviously, the pinky and the thumb is the hardest because your pinky isn't strong, right? So that's part of the issue. But also, as we, you know, can lose some of the dexterity in our hands because of and watch that again, our toes and our faces aren't getting
involved. Oh my God.